Hi, Mr. Buzz.
Hey, hi, how are you?
How are you, sir?
Thank
you. Good to see you again.
Well, good to see you.
You've been doing all right, Pope?
Yeah, I think so.
Might have pretty good. I had this over my office for a long time, but I didn't bring it because, you know, you had that little bed at the hospital, and I don't, someone say, well, there he goes walking around on the canyon. But this is made by a National Guard technician down in my district by the name of Paul Taylor. It's a treated hickory. And he and his wife do this as a hobby. And it come up with some beautiful, beautiful products.
Goodness, yes.
Isn't that beautiful thing?
Yes. And I know it has the whole family's names.
It has all the names. Yeah.
Could I have his address so I can maybe
of course, I'll
send him one
them.
Of these pictures?
I'll leave it with Smithy.
All right.
You glad to.
Well, I think this is great. You know, I've had a kind of a thing about walking sticks ever since I had to spend a few months on one after I smashed my leg.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And then with all the mugging and everything, I wondered, why did the men ever quit carrying these? Because they'd come in pretty handy if you walk through Central Park.
Sure, but that's your life, they would.
And it couldn't be called a legal weapon.
That's right. But you could use it legally.
Yes. Yep. That's a marvelous piece of
wood. I don't know how long it takes them to do that. His wife goes out and collects the wood, and then he does the carving and treating. But that's hickory. And it's one piece of wood, you know, it looks like maybe somebody took a wood, wrapped something around it, a root.
It's amazing, but, it peeled down.
Yeah,
those parts of it. Get that.
Well, good to see you, sir.
Good to see you.
I'm very happy to see you again, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
What was it you said, Tim?
You got a blackthorn walking stick from Jack Kilpatrick.
Yeah. Well, I think that's how we go to the ranch.
Okay.
Great.
Take care of that.
Yeah.
Just for a photo.
But he's a big supporter.
Yeah.
And this is it?
This is it.
All right. I'll go on the horse. Not this ranch, the old ranch. Guy was out working in the yard, and he recognized me, and he came down to the fence, you know, and he's just saying, you get any of them raccoons up around your place? And I said, oh, we see the tracks all the time. And he says, no, I mean, did you ever catch one? And I said, well, no. He says, delicious. And I said, wait a minute, I've heard about that. A raccoon, you actually? He says, yeah, but he says, there's a secret to it. And then he gave me a routine, like you marinate them in salt water or something for like 12 hours. And then you do something else. And finally, by about the third day, you put it in the oven and bake it. And then he says, and I defy you to tell it from roast pork. You go to all that trouble to wind up with the roast pork.
That's great.
Mr. President, I don't get to see you often enough, sir. But thank you very much for this opportunity. Won't you, Nell, this is Carl from Annapolis, Mississippi.
Nice to see you.
Her daughter, Allison.
Allison.
And Bubba Sicaro.
Yes.
That's ZU.
Yes.
You got that?
Yes.
ZU.
I had a chance to thank you because I know all the support that you've been.
In the Haiti campaign, Mr. President, he was very much involved in your campaign organization in Mississippi. Been a long time active Republican. Said,
I
just, if I could just bring my family
to
meet the president,
there I'm glad that you did. Why don't we all get in and
get
a picture?
Right here.
Are we smiling, Bubba?
Much as I smile.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Well, I'm delighted to see you.
Thank you.
Have a chance to say thanks to you. And to tell you what you're
We know that.
That's great.
Thank you very
Actually,
much.
Their hometown, Natchez, is not my district, but I do kind of sneak up out of my district a little bit every now and then and do a little work and count on Bubba. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you for being on. All right.
Thank you
very much. This is the day after our 34th.
Oh.
That's right. It was yesterday.
Yeah.
Okay. That's great.
But
We'll see you later.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks, sir.
Why is it that I always feel guilty tearing up all the pretty red?
Something different in the body. Oh, it is. That's exactly what it is. You want to take him upstairs?
I think about it.
Animated in West Virginia. Western West Virginia.
I was president the other day. And
Mr. President, this is the public report of the Vice President's Task Force. It's being released today. I think we feel that it's an excellent public version of an excellent official report to use. And our thought is that this should not only receive wide public distribution, but it should also be distributed abroad by the U.S. information agency to let our allies and our friends to give them an idea of what we
Well, thank you very much. Thank you for all your work on this, and I know how much effort you put in, and the Vice President on that, and I agree with you about the distribution. I know you're both going in to report to the press now.
We've got another way. We need to say that again.
Sir?
All right.
Give a little spiel.
All right. Closer.
How was the work? Mr. President, this is the, a copy of the public report of the Vice President's Task Force on Combating Terrorism. If you recall, the official classified report was delivered to you in December, and this represents all of the material that was in that classified report, the only difference being we extracted those sensitive, in a classified sense, pieces of information. We intend this to be given wide distribution, both in this country, and I think it could very well be distributed to our friends and allies and like-minded citizens abroad to give them, let them know how determined we are in combating this threat to international terrorism.
Well, thank you very much, and thank you for all the hard work that you all put in on this.
Well, the pleasure was in the satisfaction, Mr. President.
Mr. President, if Congress turns down your aid request to the Contras, sir, are you going to have to consider sending U.S. troops?
There is no request for such troops. There is no plan on our part, and whoever took something out of my remarks the other day, I think was distorting.
I take it then, sir, if others try to cast this vote as an either-or proposition, that is, either the money or troops, they would be wrong.
They would.
Hey, lights.
This way. This way.
Camera will be left.
And we will not try to do this ourselves, Mr. Vice President. You have, you might want to have USIA further develop the portfolio. It was a
great staff and really dedicated to the law. So let's see what happens.
Everyone in the
No overhead.
How do we have our lunch?
Services. No more. Our grip board is the same. See you again, sir.
Hi. There will be, hi, Mickey, all of you. There will be two press waves. The first one is only the clickers, and the second has sound. So they make sure that I don't say anything inappropriate and make a few remarks while the second wave is in.
Off camera or?
Perfectly scripted. The truth is, I didn't say it. I still think of the men of them saying it.
But you should.
It wasn't bad.
I was thinking.
Get a good smile, Tom.
Get close.
Governor of Texas, Tom?
Sounds good.
L-E-L-O-E.
L-E-F-L-E-R.
And his horse, Liberty.
Right, lights, please. Thank you.
You fellas up there, what we call in Hollywood an over-the-shoulder shot.
They pick their best shoulders. The hunter's got his name on his back.
Take it off the back of your head.
Now, he won't recognize the back of his head because he never goes the other way.
Oh, no.
It's always straight ahead.
Or lucky.
Just don't say the wrong thing.
Well, if the issue we're facing and the stakes are properly understood, we should be able to muster bipartisan support. We've seen some evidence of this emerging already in some of the committee votes, but we've got a long way to go. And what the Congress is about to decide goes right to the heart, I think, of our national security. And I intend to bring this issue directly to the people in the television address. And I know that you will work with us right up to the day of the vote to see to it that your colleagues and the American people understand how great the stakes are. Even as we meet, Nicaragua's dictator is back in Havana meeting with Castro. And I think it's significant that Bayardo Arce, one of Nicaragua's 9 commandantes, was the first foreigner asked to address the recent Soviet Party Congress. It's up to us to persuade the members of Congress of what the consequences will be for Nicaragua, for Central America, and for the safety of our own country if we fail to act. And that's what we propose to do, is act all out for the next 2 weeks.
Lights.
Mr. President, do you believe that people who vote against you on the Hill are supporting the communists?
If so, inadvertently.
And you don't agree then with Mr. Buchanan that the Democratic Party is faced with the choice of supporting you or supporting the communists?
Well, it's what the choice comes down to, whether it is knowingly or not. And I've had enough experience with communist subversion back in my former profession to know that a great many people are deceived and not aware that what they're doing is inimical to the interests of the United States.
Thank you.
Couldn't just be an honest disagreement with you on the way to proceed?
You'd have to be stretching pretty far because we're going to make the facts so plain. I don't have any way to comment on that.
What time is your television address, sir? You said you were going to make one. Do you know what day yet?
I don't know whether the date has been decided or not. I'm the last to know.
Hey, Sam, let's ask a business interview. San Diego, right down here.
I just said that by breath.
He leaned away from me.
Well, anyway, let me repeat again. It's good of you to come here, and it's good to have your GRIP organization back for a visit. We ought to do it more often.
We're with it.
Well, clearly, our biggest challenge for the next 2 weeks will be to secure adoption of our package of assistance to the Russia. As I understand it, the 4 committees, Armed Services, House, Foreign Affairs, Intelligence, and Appropriations, are dealing with this, and one of them, Armed Services, has voted it out with a favorable vote. Intelligence and Appropriations voted unfavorably, but one of those was a voice vote, so that there are some people there that aren't really on the record as being opposed, if we can persuade them.
Well, that's the one that passed, Mr. President. Huh? The Armed Services Committee, that passed with a voice vote.
I thought there was one
and appropriations.
The defeat is a voice vote also. Well, but it was on, as you know, the Michael Murtha resolution, and it's been, it'll complete action, I guess, in the committees today, and then go to rules, and then to the floor on the 19th.
I understand it's when it's scheduled. Is that square with your information, Trent?
19th district.
I would have been on television by then.
Good.
I know that most of you in this room supported covert military aid of freedom fighters last year. Unfortunately, our efforts didn't prevail. With that in mind, it becomes even more important to have your full support again this year. In fact, I would hope the entire WHIP organization will be working to help pass Michael Murphy in the House. Now I'm going to call on George Shultz to describe the package.